Alright, first and foremost, I'm going to say all praises be to Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, Bahashem, Rokah, Kodash. And I'm going to say double honors to the apostles and elders of Great Millstone. Shalom to the sincere elect, teaching this truth and faith and sincerity through the spirit and power of Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, Bahashem, Rokah, Kodash. Alright, man, so a quick topic I want to speak on, man. It's is a clip that was video that was posted by the elder Manatis Akbar, right? I believe from the Great Millstone South Carolina camp. And just the first couple minutes, the compilation videos, man, it shows you why two-thirds, which, you know, that's based upon the wicked of Israel that's in the land of, like, America, you know, the scripture says, you know, that in all of the land, two parts, that applies over there. But then as well, you know, the wicked of our people scattered amongst the four corners, man. But obviously it starts over there in Babylon. But Israelites that are in this mentality, because remember the scripture says that the time has come that judgment will begin at the house of God, man. So, you know, that applies unto those who are Israelites that know the truth. So it don't matter whether you're in Babylon, whether you're in London, whether you're in Amsterdam, it don't matter where you are. If you're an Israelite and you're in, or you call yourself being in the truth, right, it gonna start with you if you ain't in the right spirit, man. Now, you know when I was watching this, man, I said these niggas gotta die. There's nothing, there ain't nothing left unless they turn from their ways and repent. These motherfuckers gonna die, you know. And I'm sorry for using that kind of language, but it's like, bro, we're about to enter in a time of trouble that's never been, right? For the past couple years, there's been all types of lockdowns and shutdowns. There's been people losing jobs, right? People dying, right? You know, wars and rumors of wars, people pulling down statues. There's so much that is going on, and it's getting worse. But all Jake is focused on is how to be a part of the world and pretend to be in the truth. And you can fool man, you know, but you can't fool the Lord, man. So without further ado, I'm going to play some of the clips that go into scriptures. Now, you know, the first thing Jake gonna say is, well, where the scriptures just say that you can't party? Huh? So where does the scriptures say that you can't party? Bruv, what mentality do you think the Lord, all right? What mentality do you think the Lord had before his time of trouble, man, right? What mentality do you think he had before he got crucified? You know what I'm saying? It was a serious time. And where, at the same way he went through his time of trouble, it's the same way we're going to go through our time of trouble. So the example of how tense and serious things are is what our Lord experienced, right? We're about to enter a time. I'm so pumped, right? I'm going to just get a few scriptures first, and we'll come back to that one, right? No, not Isaiah 16. This is John 16, right? I'm going to read this, man. This is John 16 and 2. They shall put you out of the synagogues. Yea, the time cometh that whosoever killeth you will think he doeth the Most High service. Bro, that's the time we're entering into. So we're coming into a time whereby having us on TV as thugs and criminals and all that stuff, people gonna think having you killed is doing God's work. Dude, I don't think you know what that means. Bro, we're coming into a time where people are gonna think killing us is doing God's service. Like, not as this, not to use as the same example, but like even Paul, right? Like, until Paul was converted and healed, he thought he was doing God's work, right? So, in the state of wickedness, that's what's about to take place. Now, Paul, when he was doing what he was doing, came in a like a sincere spirit. You know what I'm saying? So that's why he eventually got converted and healed. But in this time, these guys gonna come with hate and know that they're off and wicked, but still don't care. So really, it's really worse, because the person can do acts of wickedness, like in ignorance. But then as well, like, we're coming into a time where these people gonna come in at complete hate and envy. The scripture says that we shall be hated of all men for the Lord's name's sake. So what in the fuck would make you think that this is a mentality or spirit to be in? Now, I bet you, you know, if you ask any of them, what's the MOTB? Well, you know, it, it's a picture of the, you know, white man. If you go down and, you know, if you pray to his false gods, you know what I'm saying? But if you ask him, bro, yo, man, like, I want to have a party and speakers and music. Oh, yeah, bro. Yeah, man. Yeah, you see? But if you ask any of them about scriptures, they're going to say, well, that don't mean that. And then, yeah, nah. But then, you know what I'm saying? Let me keep playing the video. Man, guy here is a MF what's his name? You know this guy right here is a MF Doom. You know what I mean? I don't know what he's playing at. How is this edifying? I mean, in what way is edifying? Like, what are you gonna learn from this? Man, I ain't even gonna watch all that, man. And then even here. We gon' burn him with the open flame. Yeah. We gon' cut him with the devil and we gon' shed him like the wine press. We gon' shed him like the wine press. And your teeth in your mouth, that's it. And Jake don't even think. You're actually there on videos saying we gon' this and we gon' do that and we gon' do that, not making mention of the Lord, man. So when Esau comes across this, oh, these guys are threatening violence and all that stuff. But anyway, let me play a bit of this. Ain't a reason you should live. Use a cancer to the core. Use a dancer, use a whore. Watch everyone and all. Every nation been involved in the vexing of the Lord. We gonna burn them with the open flame. We gonna cut them with the double edge. You bug out, man. It would have been mad to just stay in the world, man. So anyway, man. Let me just get a few scriptures, man. Because, look, like, Jake always going to say, well, so where did the scripture say that you can't party? Where does the scripture say you can't do this? Where do you just... But the scripture says, right? You know what? Yeah. I'm doing too much talking. I'm going to just read the scriptures. This is Isaiah 30 and 9. That this is a rebellious people. Lying children. Children that will not hear the law of the Lord. Right? We say to the seers, see not. To the and to the prophets, prophesy not unto us right things. Speak unto us smooth things. Prophesy deceits, man. And that's what Jake really want. Jake don't want the truth. Bro, the whole purpose of us being in this faith is one, is in hopes to be saved, man. Or at least that's what you're supposed to be in the truth for. In the hopes to be saved. Not for partying. Let the world go, man. Yes, you know, spiritual, that, like I spoke about it. Yes, I spoke about this. Let the... What the fuck do you want, man? You fucking eat them, right, man? Like, let the world go. Like, you gotta let the world go, man. You know what I'm saying? You gotta let the world go. And people just don't want to let the world go. You know, it's a joke, man. But anyway, it says, we say to the seers, see not. And to the prophets, prophesy not. Prophesy not unto us right things. Speak unto us smooth things. Prophesy deceits. And that's what Jake want to hear. Lies. All right? Jake all want to hear lies. You know? This, that. That's what they want to hear is lies, bro. They want to hear lies and just bullshit. Like, Jake, all these people want to hear is, hey, bro, it's possible to be in the world and in the truth. And that ain't the case, man. Anyway, it says, get you out of the way. Turn aside from the past. Cause the Holy One of Israel to cease before us. And you know, and Jake, all these type of people anyway, all they want to do is appear righteous, but still be fucking wicked. You know? Oh, yeah, you know, like, come on, how is this edifying? We gonna burn them with the open. This guy's a demon as well, man. Treat him like the wine, Chris. Treat him like the wine, Chris. You niggas ain't doing nothing, not fried by. You niggas will get the bus and crack and gentrify. You niggas won't even touch them, get a little money. And your homies, you say you're fucking too, nigga. Talking about what you do, nigga. Talking about how you move. Let me just skip through this, man.
Hold up, what was that? You throwing up gang signs in the name of your How About You Help Show?
The ISUPK, goddammit. The ISUPK, goddammit.
Most higher price I'm here, I'm doing it. Most higher price I'm here.
These people just want to wear garments, right? And look righteous, but still be wicked.
I'm making sure everybody got the wine, they got their water, and they got their grape juice. Look, why do you want to stay in the world when you ain't getting no women like that?
Right.
You know what I mean? The women don't like you. Right. Your feet stink.
Right.
You're sitting on the couch all day. You don't got a job. Right. So you might as well come into the truth.
Right.
So that you can get some jobs and you can get a girl.
Right.
You see? You see? And he's made no mention of coming in the truth for spirituality. Turning on to the Lord. You know what I mean? Like, and repenting. He's only made mention of just being in the world, man. You know? Well, really, that's it. I'm not saying to have a job is of the world or to have a wife is of the world, but the purpose of being a part of this faith isn't for those gains, man. If you want to have a job, if you want to have a woman, if you want to have a this, that's fucked out, man. But anyway, let's get Ezekiel 2, right? Hold on 1 sec. Right, it says Ezekiel 2 and 3. And he said unto me, Son of man, I send thee to the children of Israel, to a rebellious nation that have rebelled against me. They and their fathers have transgressed me, even unto this very day. For they are an impudent children and stiff-hearted. I do send thee unto them, and thou shalt say unto them, Thus saith the Lord power. And they, whether they will hear or whether they will forbear, for they are a rebellious house, yet shall know that there have been a prophet among them. Right? And thou, son of man, be not afraid of them, neither be afraid of their words, though briars and thorns be with thee, and thou dost dwell among scorpions. So the scriptures refers to our people as scorpions. But the most stiff-headed people are people who claim to be a part of the truth that can't let the world go. But that's cool, though, because this truth is only for those who are the elect. Be not afraid of their words, nor be dismayed at their looks, though they be a rebellious house. And we've been seeing that, man. Jake's talking about you can have sex on the Sabbath day. Like, why would you want to have sex on the Sabbath? Jake says you can pop your woman in the ass. Why would you want to pop your her man in the ass? Does that even come on, man? You can smoke weed, you can do this, you can, it's like, bro, you know, the Bible is not the word of God, but the word of God's contained in the Bible. You know, coming up against the apostles and elders that taught you, bunch of wickedness, man. But anyway, this is Ezekiel chapter 7 and 25. Destruction cometh, and they shall seek peace, and there shall be none. So since you're trying to seek the Lord and repent, when the time of destruction comes, you're going to be seeking peace. But there ain't gonna be anything there for you. Please, no, nigga. You know what I'm saying? That's how it's gonna be, man. Cause you wanna stay here and play games. Okay, you wanna stay here and play games? We gonna see what the game's gonna do for you in a time of trouble, man. We gonna see what the game's gonna do for you in a time of trouble, man. All right, this is Ezekiel 21 and 9. It says, Son of man, prophesy and say, thus saith the Lord, say a sword is sharpened and is also furbished. It is sharpened to make a sword slaughter. It is furbished that it may the litter. Should we then make mirth? No. It contemneth the rod of my son as every tree. And he furbished it, that it may be handled. This sword is sharpened, and it is furbished to give into the hand of the slayer, and the slayer is Esau. Cry and howl, son of man, for it shall be upon my people. It shall be upon all the princes of Israel. Terrors by reason of the sword shall be upon my people. Smite therefore upon thy thigh. And that's what we're actually doing, but guess what? Jake just want to make mirth. But that's cool. Hey, man, to any Israelite out there that is actually really sincere about this truth, this is not the mentality to having this truth, man. This is not the spirit to be in, especially as we're approaching a time of trouble. Look, man, when we're establishing a kingdom, so that's when we can, you know, have fun in righteousness, in a right mind, in faith. But if you want to party here in Babylon, you know, again, of course, you know, brothers, like, independently, like, on their own, might have a little a cookout and barbecue, or you might go to a little bar here and there. All right, cool. But again, that's not to be to be pushed out there, man. Like, as in the main thing, a part of this truth. Because all these camps that's on the screen now, all they push is being a part of this world, but then a sprinkle of certain scriptures here and there.
So you might as well come into the truth, right, so that you can get some jobs and you can get a girl. Right.
So come in the truth to get a job and a girl, not salvation.
Right. At least do that. Right. Why the commander doing your honor? So you might as well come into the truth, right, so that you can get some jobs and you can get a girl.
You feel me? Everything was glorious. If you didn't make it, you missed out. You feel me? And ain't no trying to make it up next year. This is one of one. You feel me? Shout out Commander General Yohana. General Mahayman.
Right. Now, the scripture says, let a woman be what? Adorned in modest apparel. Her nails, man, you know. Her hair. Hoop earrings. This is nothing but a farm for her adultery, man. Teach the word. But guess what? Jake just want to just be in the world and play games. All the generals. Okay.
If you ain't in the ISUPK and you ain't smoking weed, I don't know what the fuck you're doing with your life, man.
You know? Let me get that.
If you ain't in the ISUPK and you ain't smoking weed, I don't know what the fuck you're doing with your life, man. You know?
You
know what I'm saying? Like, this right here is heaven on earth, man.
If you ain't in the ISUPK and you ain't smoking weed, I don't know what the hell to tell you. This is heaven on earth. What? Being in some boots and smoking weed in hell. Man, damn. I mean, if that's heaven on earth, man, then the kids, then boy, man, I don't know what to tell you, man. Now, since we're approaching the time of trouble, just ask yourself, how is this a benefit? Like, what benefit do you get from this right here? Where's the benefit in this? But anyway, I'm gonna end with this scripture, man, because this kind of topic, you know, you can speak for eternity. This is a 2 Peter 3 and 11, right? It says, seeing then that all these things shall be dissolved, what manner of persons ought you to be in all holy conversation and godliness, looking for and hasting unto the coming of the day of the Lord, Yahweh Ba'ashem Yahweh Shai, wherein the heavens being on fire shall be dissolved, and the elements shall melt with fervent heat. So seeing all these things shall be dissolved, well this kingdom started with Babylon, you know, this kingdom, the power structure is going to be taken away from Esau, but the only land that's going to receive permanent destruction is Babylon, the great, which is America. So seeing this is all going to happen, what manner of person are we supposed to be? What, in mirth? In bullshit? How the fuck does... I'm sorry I'm getting angry, but this is not the time, man. Leave the world alone, man. Now, this is only for those who are the elect anyway. So everyone has a part to play. But this stuff makes me angry, man. Bro, we're about to enter in a time of World War III, right? We're about to enter a time of martial law. We're about to enter a time of mass deaths. Cannibalism's coming back. There's so much things that are about to happen. But Jake are obsessed with party and bullshit and party. You know, that's what we're fucking obsessed with. And that's all right. Because this is only for those who have the elect. Scripture says the day of the Lord shall come as a thief in the night. But the scripture says that we, the children of light, you know, Lord willing, those who are in faith, that this day is not going to overtake us as a thief. So guess what? There are people out there that are going to be alive to this truth, alive to the ways of righteousness, and in the right spirit. But then at the same time, there are people that ain't going to be in the spirit and are going to get caught up, right? Like, Jake, you know where the fringes. Oh, keep the law, brother. The fringes, arc, and all of that. But are in a state of mouth. Hey, that's why these people are going to be taken out, lest they turn to the Lord and repent. Right, so with that, I'm going to say, well, praise be to you. How about Shema, Shabbat, Shema, Kaq, Kodash, double honest, possible, and elders, great, more stone, and it's time I'm going to say, Shalom.